my face while the storms howl above me and there's no hiding place. Mid the crash of the thunder, precious Lord, hear my cry. Keep me safe till the storm passes by. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand. Keep me safe till the storm passes by.
Many times Satan whispered, there is no use to try, for there's no end of sorrow, there's no hope by and by. But I know thou art with me, and tomorrow I'll rise. When the storms never darken the skies,
till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand.
Again, everyone, you may end up hearing a little bit of noise in the background of this. I'm trying to get this recorded, and we have air compressors and nail guns being run. I've got everything stacked out over here where I can get to it and pick it up. I've trying to find different quiet places around the campus. But I really like being with the stained glass window. It really gives some familiarity. And it also is just such a peaceful area here in the meditation room. And I really enjoy recording in here. So I'll apologize in advance in case you hear any noise in the background or things going on. This is also a time of a lot of traffic here in the lower part of the Palm Center building, and so thank you for your understanding and your patience. Thank you for the many blessings that you pour out to one another. I do hope that you appreciate the music that we led off the service with. It's an amazing thing when we realize that even though we are in some of the storms these days, God still takes care of us till the storm passes by, doesn't he? Isn't that an amazing song? And I try to include the lyrics just in case you'd like to sing along with it. So blessings to you. Again, thank you for joining with us today. I would like to go ahead and share the prayer for the week that comes to us from Chaplain Patricia Van. She is from Westminster Gardens in Tallahassee. And she writes this prayer for us to share this week. Gracious Heavenly Father, We come to you with hearts filled with praise. Lord, we are grateful for your strength and unrelenting power, the gifts of family, laughter, care, and compassion sustain us. May we never take such gifts for granted. You, dear Lord, remain our strong tower, a place of refuge, a safe haven in the midst of the storms of life. We need divine intervention and help from the Holy Spirit in a very real and intimate way this day and for all time. Lord, your promises and faithfulness remain steadfast throughout eternity, and we are ever so thankful. Your word declares in 2 Timothy 1:7, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Father, take our fears, pour out your power, show us how to spiritually love others as you have loved us. Keep our minds focused on matters of the heart and your lovely grace. In your loving name we pray, amen and amen. What a beautiful prayer. What a beautiful prayer. Now, today we're going to be taking a look at Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 9 through 12. It is a very peaceful passage. It is one that will speak to our hearts, and I really pray that the message would speak to you. I know that it has spoken to me, and it gives us all pause to ponder what's going on and where we are and how we're living and what we are doing. I've titled the message, The Metal of Companionship. And as we take a look at this passage, just allow it to speak to you and to help locate you where you are and bring us all together in such a remarkable way. Now, when I read this passage, it's going to come up on the screen. I'm reading from the New Living Translation. If you have a Bible, you can follow along. If not, like I said, it will come up on your screen and you'll be able to follow along there. And so let's focus in on God's Word for a while, shall we, as I read. Two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. But someone who falls alone is in real trouble. Likewise, two people lying close together can keep each other warm. But how can one be warm alone? A person standing alone can be attacked and defeated. But two can stand back to back and conquer. Three are even better, for a triple braided cord is not easily broken. God's word for God's people for us today. Now, from the dawn of creation, God's word tells us that it is not good for man to be alone. Now, before you get too excited about me saying man, I'm not being sexist here. Adam needed Eve, and honestly, Eve needed Adam. So those words were spoken before Eve was even fashioned. The point is it's not good for anyone to be alone in any circumstance. It is not good for anyone to be alone. If fellowship is important, then companionship takes us a step higher. Wouldn't you agree? It is a process of going beyond sharing the same space. It truly means having, as it were, the same heartbeat. The same heartbeat. Metal means to have a staying quality and a strength of spirit. So let's take this passage apart here just a little bit and let's see what it says to each of us. I've got 5 points, so you can follow along, and it kind of gives you an opportunity to time the length of the sermon and gives you hope for its conclusion, I guess. They always say, pastors, preachers, never tell them how many points of the sermon you have because they'll be counting down. Well, I trust your judgment, and I trust that you'll stay right on point and stay right on target with us. First of all, one of the things that we learn about companionship is that there is productivity in companionship. There is an encouragement when two people work together, whether it be online, on the phone, in writing. Remember the days of person to person when groups could gather, and now we're a little limited in that, but we understand and we need to comprehend the fact that we work together whether we are in person or not. We all have phones, we all have writing ability. We can pass each other in the hallway. Some of you have online. If you're watching this, maybe you have online, maybe you don't. Maybe you don't have a computer at all. Maybe you're just watching on the TV channel. Whatever the case may be, the fact that we are spending time together, focusing on God's Word, the fact that we call one another, the fact that we encourage one another, that is accomplishing something, and that is called productivity. Now, two heads are better than one. Wouldn't you agree? Sometimes, in the way that I think, sometimes I need a third head to kind of help take up some of the slack. But two heads are better than one because it helps with the perception of the goal. It helps to understand what is trying to be accomplished and where you're headed and what you're trying to do. And it also helps with the utilization of materials on hand. You can look at a problem, see what you have on hand, and utilize the materials, utilize the resources that you have to get the task done. That's the way that it works. And so people tend to think things through better when there's more than one individual. Now, along with the productivity, creativity is the byproduct. We call that brainstorming. Brainstorming. Creativity, you see, finds its refinement in companionship. You ever been talking with someone and one of you will make the statement, you know, I've been thinking, or that gives me a good idea, or hey, let's talk about this for a second. I'm thinking about something. And you start talking that out and you realize the endless possibilities that are there because of the fact that you've discussed it. So creativity is a real byproduct of companionship. I mean, no matter where you are, no matter what groups you have been in, when you get a group together to work on a problem, so many different perceptions, so many different ideas, so many different possibilities come to light. So what you need to try to do and to understand is chat with someone, pick up the phone, chat with someone, share with them in whatever way that you can. If you can maintain social distancing and be able to find a nice quiet spot to talk, that's an amazing thing. It's a great opportunity to just get to know one another and to be able to face a problem together. Now, secondly, there is encouragement in companionship. Cheering each other on. A kind word can give a boost when all seems to be lost. Being cheerleaders for each other. Taking a moment to just say something nice, to give a compliment, to share with someone. That person that we share that encouragement with is given a boost, and they feel uplifted and they feel appreciated. But it is also reciprocal to ourselves. Encouraging someone else helps us. Do you know that if you're ever feeling discouraged or downhearted or just swamped, one of the best things that you can do for yourself and your own well-being is to try to be an encouragement and try to help someone else? That is an excellent principle of life, isn't it? It makes such a difference. Now, it is that verbal motivation that produces the steam power, you see, to drive the wheels of our individual forward progress, if you will. the words of encouragement, the words of appreciation, that just puts fire to the boiler, doesn't it? It really does. It makes a huge difference. And it can push us forward when we feel like we are really running out of steam. It makes all the difference in the world. Now, thirdly, there is help in companionship. Now, we all understand and we all recognize that it can be quite discouraging to be alone. I hear you. I understand. I identify with that. Sometimes I feel the exact same way. Now, when we tend to think of ourselves and our own situation, we tend to be self-isolating. I know that we are supposed to be maintaining social distancing, like I said, and to really be careful and to distance ourselves and to take care of ourselves. I understand that we need to do that. And because we do that, we tend to only think of ourselves and only think of our own situation. Well, when we hear of others needing help, it lets us know that we are not truly alone in our circumstances, in our feelings, or in our perception. When we share with one another, okay, in the encouragement phase, if we share with one another, that feedback and that brainstorming helps us to understand we're not the only one feeling that way. So we recognize that we really are not alone. We may be by ourselves in our apartments. We may be by ourselves in the car or on a park bench. We may think that we are totally alone, but really we're not, because other people are joined emotionally and spiritually with us because they're facing the same types of struggles and problems. Now, when we help someone else, I'm trying to find the word here. When we help someone else, it helps us to share from our experience and to be able to help reach them where they are. Okay? So having one help someone else up, having one to help us up when we fall makes all the difference. So can't we understand then that our ability of being able to help someone else up is also an encouragement to them? Not just someone to tell us how to get up, but someone to lend a hand to lift and support. Remember the story of Peter and John at the gate where they saw the cripple? When they said, pick up your bed and walk. When you I don't have anything else to give you, but this I give you. And then they reached out with their hand and helped lift him to his feet. They just didn't demand. They actually lended a hand in his restoration and in his healing, in his encouragement. So sometimes it's just a matter of reaching out spiritually and emotionally with a hand to help uplift and encourage and to get somebody back on their feet again. So there is help in companionship. Fourth, there is a warmth in companionship. There is nothing so cold as a cold shoulder. It hurts to be ignored, doesn't it? It hurts to be unappreciated. It breaks our hearts to be rejected. And sometimes it is the perception of a cold shoulder that does the damage, when it's in reality not a cold shoulder at all. Those folks that we think may have given us a cold shoulder may have other things on their minds as well. We don't have any idea what all's going on in the back of someone's mind. We don't know the circumstances and situations that they're in. And so sometimes we have to be very, very careful that we don't judge their actions strictly on the surface. Dig down a little bit. Give them the benefit of the doubt. Wouldn't you appreciate that from someone if they catch you on a bad day and you say, oh, I'm just so sorry that I acted that way or I said what I said. I just had a lot on my mind and I was just upset. I'm sorry that I took it out on you. Please forgive me. So we think we were rejected. And if we think that we have been rejected, that becomes our perceived reality, doesn't it? If that's what we think and that's what we believe, that's what becomes real to us. So what if we could take the time and to realize that someone else's curt response or short words or bit of an attitude, what if we took just a moment to say they must be hurting because that's not the person that I know, and help them and then be a word of encouragement to them, not to call them out on it, but just immediately to give them a word of encouragement and watch their countenance change. Watch their attitude change. It will be an amazing transportation, I promise you. Now, a warm heart can really make the countenance glow. Our hearts warm when they are fed with hope and when they are fed with faith. Sometimes we need to take our spiritual temperature. Now, in these days, there's all kinds of screening going on. And I can't help but chuckle. Wouldn't it be nice if we had a spiritual screening form? Wouldn't that be unique? All those questions you have to ask, where have you been? What have you done? Have you been out of the country? Have you traveled? Have you been to the hospital? Have you had this symptom, that symptom? We go down through that whole list. Well, what if we had a list similar to that that would be able to judge our spiritual well-being? When was the last time that you prayed? When was the last time you spent some time with the Word of God? When was the last time you took some quiet time and meditated and focused on spiritual things? When was the last time you took your spiritual temperature? Was it below normal? Was it normal or above normal? Think about that for a moment. We need to come up with a form. Maybe we can get together and brainstorm that idea. So sometimes we need to look at another individual and also consider our own self-perception and understand what it makes or what it takes to make someone's face light up. What is it that uplifts them? What is it that uplifts you? And couldn't someone else respond and appreciate from the very things that make the difference in your life? Now, when temperatures plunge outside, shared warmth is healthy for both. Now, that's a little difficult, we say, when you're living alone, right? You don't have anybody to cuddle with. Well, you know, what about spiritually getting close to someone, calling them up and saying, would you mind having a word of prayer with me on the phone? Would you mind sharing with me, or would you mind if I had a word of prayer with you? That is joining hearts together, and in the same way that people cuddling together, holding on to one another, the same way that we put on a warm jacket or throw a warm blanket over ourselves, in all those ways that we seek to generate heat and generate warmth, those times of encouragement with somebody else is a warming time. Those times that we can stop our busy lives and reach out to someone else. So you may have the very thing that would warm someone else's heart. You could be the answer to their discouragement. You could be their answer to their feeling cool and rejected and isolated and alone. Now, lastly, there is safety in companionship. When there's more than one, you can gang up on a problem. Together, we can do more, right? The old axiom using the word team, together everyone achieves more, or together everyone accomplishes more, however you want to break that down. Together, in partnership, and in shared experience and shared emotional ties, we can lick anything. Doesn't have to be a crowd, and you don't have to be person to person to do it. We find that safety and companionship is also an assurance that no one is left behind. No one is left to fend for themselves, reaching out to one another, encouraging one another, checking on one another makes all the difference in the world, doesn't it? I am amazed when I hear of people doing really neat things for someone that can't get out, doing grocery shopping, picking up packages in the lobby and taking it to a neighbor. Those little errands and those little things, slipping a card under someone's door, sending them an email, calling them on the phone, all those little things in the process of checking on one another and looking out for one another, those are transformative experiences for you and for the one that you are sharing with. So companionship, even in our isolation, even in our social distancing, there are ways to maintain companionship, and it is critical that we do that. Just like I started off when I said, it is not good, and this time we can say, it is not good that anyone be alone. We were created for fellowship. We were created for companionship, both with one another and with God. Divine companionship, human companionship. We even, those of us that have pets, we have relationships with our pets. It is always a good thing to share relationship, to share companionship. Now, have you noticed that everything that's been mentioned can be accomplished in ways that do not require face-to-face contact? Think of those you know that are separated by distance. Any contact makes a difference. In all these things that we have mentioned about companionship, we become better people and well-rounded spiritually. Proverbs 27:17 says this, iron sharpens iron. So a man sharpens the countenance of his friend, or one individual sharpens the countenance of their friend. When we realize that our best companion is Christ, then all other companions are bound together by a common thread. As a result, we can change the world one companionship, one relationship at a time. Really, God places it in our hands and in our hearts. And we've been given our marching orders to make a difference in someone else's life, to reach out to God, to allow Him to encourage us, and then use that filling of our own fuel tank from God to reach out to someone else and be a word of encouragement to them too. Amen. Let's join in our prayer together as we close our time. Creator God, we ask you to bless our Westminster community and all who live and work within it. May this place be filled with deep caring, welcoming hospitality, and dedicated respect. May all who visit here be greeted with warmth and kindness. May all who live here be graced with God and peace. May all who serve here do so in the spirit of Jesus, whose deep love and dedication to healing touched all he encountered. Amen. Again, thank you for being with us. Thank you in sharing in this time together. If you have a moment and you're able to go into My W Life, you'll find some really neat resources that are there. You'll find all the chapel messages there. You'll find some scripture reading guides. There's just a lot of things under the spiritual tab in My W Life. Check it out and allow it to be a blessing to you. I put all of those things there in order to help you with your companionship, to help you with your ministry to one another. Now, in just a moment, a song is going to play, and the title of it is Where No One Stands Alone. I trust that it'll be a song that would be a blessing to you. It is an old song, it's an old quartet song, and I trust that you will enjoy the music and enjoy the words as you focus on its message. God bless you, and may you have a blessed week.
Once I stood in the night with my head bowed low in the darkness as black as could be, and my heart felt alone and I cried.
like a king, I may live in a palace so tall, with great riches to come.